A big thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring today's video.
So this week, surprisingly, our viewers have voted for a video on the fascinating topic of anti-aging research. Where are we right now with anti-aging research? And where will we be in the future?
And most importantly, could we maybe one day live for hundreds or even thousands of years? Or maybe even forever? So that we can live on Mars and see humanity spread to the stars? Well, let's find out.
A person born 1900 years ago, say in the time of the Roman Emperor Trajan, would spend his or her entire life in a quite unchanging world. The technological level would be virtually unchanged at the time of birth and at the time of death. Same technology, similar political situation, same architecture, same cities. Compare that to a person born in the year 1900 and living until the 1980s. That person would have grown up as a child in a world where the horse was the most common means of transportation. The automobile was very rare yet, and the airplane was not even invented. 80 years later, this person would die in a completely changed world. The automobile is nothing special anymore. Airplane travel is quite common, and people even landed on the moon. Thus, many people feel the desire to witness more. What wonders could we see in the coming decades? Or in 100 years? At the same time, lifespan is also increasing due to better medical technology and healthcare. A person would be extremely lucky to even reach the age of 70 2000 years ago. While nowadays, this is absolutely nothing special anymore. It currently seems that 120 years is the age limit, which is somehow built into our systems. And very few people are lucky enough to reach an age of above 100.
It is more than understandable that many people want to experience a long and healthy life. We want to see humanity expand to the solar system. We want to see colonies and cities on the moon and on Mars. We want to see interstellar probes sending back pictures from planets around other star systems. We want to witness the first findings of alien life and many more such amazing things. But with an average life expectancy of a bit over 80 years, most people will not be able to witness all these miracles. Or will they? As technology advances, so does the relatively new field of anti-aging and rejuvenation. The goal of this emerging field of biotechnology is to find ways not to only extend human lifespan, but to also extend human health span. Because what good is it to live over 100 years of age if you spend the last decades blind, deaf, and in a wheelchair? We are talking about reaching an insanely high age in good health and also at good mental health. No Alzheimer's, no dementia, in good shape until the end. As it turns out, a few visionaries are actually already working on that. We talk about disruptive technologies on this channel a lot, and the field of biotechnology is a very disruptive field which will get more and more important in the next years and decades. But is it technologically even possible to extend human lifespan to, say, 150, 200, or even thousands of years? For that, we must define what aging even is. According to Aubrey De Grey, a giant in the field of anti-aging research, who probably doesn't look like Gandalf the Grey by accident, as Gandalf in The Lord of the Rings is practically an immortal being of supreme wisdom and power, has defined aging as being the accumulated intra and extracellular damage in the human body over time. This means that the human body can be treated as a complicated biological machine, but in essence, a machine. The same way an old car gets rusty and starts breaking down with age and needs constant repairs and maintenance to keep it going, the same way a human would need constant repair and rejuvenation technology to keep it going. And if you want to support our YouTube channel and help us to continue talking about all kinds of disruptive technologies, then please check out our favorite online learning platform, Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community where millions of people come together to take the next step in their creative journey. With thousands of inspiring classes for creative and curious people on topics including programming, illustration, design, and so many more.
We have been learning on Skillshare for quite a while now, and lately we were trying out Productivity Today, Managing Attention in the Digital Age. Here, Kevin Siskar, CEO of a successful startup, teaches you in only 34 minutes how you can focus your attention on the most important things and not get so easily distracted by digital media.
What makes Skillshare different from other online learning platforms is that there are class projects where you can practice your new skill, get feedback from the teacher, and exchange with the other students.
The best value for money would be the annual subscription at less than $10 a month. And if you use our special link here, you would even get a free trial of the Skillshare premium membership. So be sure to use our special link. Join Skillshare today and start to learn anything you like, from home or anywhere you prefer.
Furthermore, Aubrey identified 7 different classes of aging, and he shows it very nicely in this table here.
In order to find ways to fix these different types of aging damage, Aubrey De Grey founded the SENS Research Foundation, a non-profit foundation that funds innovative research at universities across the world. Based in Mountain View, California. Link in the video description. And fascinatingly, they are making really good progress. 20 years ago, there was not even a clear understanding of what aging is. And now, thanks to visionaries such as Aubrey De Grey, treatment methods are being explored in order to fix all these 7 types of aging damage. And some treatment methods are already being tested right now. And many more will become available in the next 10 years. Extracellular aggregates, so basically junk outside of cells, will be treated with immunotherapeutic clearance, so basically removing the junk from between cells. This can be achieved by amyloid-targeting vaccines, which also combat Alzheimer's disease and are currently already in advanced clinical trials. Death-resistant or dysfunctional cells are another big problem, which will be solved by developing a drug that targets these cells specifically, or by stimulating the immune system to selectively seek out and kill the target cells. Another cause of aging is matrix stiffening. This causes artery walls to stiffen at higher age, organs to become inelastic, and ultimately the heart to fail. Here, enzymes could be reprogrammed or engineered to target crosslinks, which are bonds that are responsible for the degradation of elasticity in the human tissue. In order to overcome junk in the cells, modified or engineered enzymes, which target and break down this junk, would be used.
Another problem are mitochondrial mutations. Mitochondria are the cell power plants that basically generate the energy by chemical processes to power the cells. But unfortunately, they mutate over time and start messing up more and more. Overcoming this might be achieved by inserting backup copies of mitochondrial genes into the mitochondria. That way, even if the original genes in the mitochondria are damaged, the backup copies will be able to supply the proteins needed to keep normal energy production going, allowing the cellular power plants to continue humming along normally and preventing them from entering into the toxic, mutant metabolic state. Next are cancerous cells. The older we are, the higher the probability that cells go rogue and mutate into cancer cells that then multiply and take over the body. This could be overcome by hindering cancer cells to live forever, by removing their genes which enable them to multiply indefinitely. The last aging damage, cell loss and tissue atrophy, could be overcome by stem cell therapy and tissue engineering, meaning new organs or tissue could be grown from stem cells, which then are genetically identical to the body in which they are to be inserted. Many advanced clinical trials for stem cell therapy, especially for defeating cancer, are being carried out right now. So, 2 out of the 7 treatments for the different types of aging damage are undergoing clinical trials right now. With Aubrey De Grey estimating that all of these 7 aging damages will be available for treatment in the next 20 years.
Another giant in this emerging field of anti-aging biotechnology is David Sinclair from the Harvard Medical School. He differs in some points from Aubrey De Grey, in that his theory is that aging essentially comes from the loss of digital or analog information. David Sinclair calls this the relocalization of chromatin modifiers hypothesis. In his view, epigenetic changes due to relocalization of chromatin factors in response to DNA damage may be a chief cause of aging. This means that in response to a DNA break, proteins that regulate gene expression move to the break to help repair, resulting in gene expression changes in young cells. This process is reset upon completion of DNA repair. However, not all proteins make it back to where they came from, which leads to gene expression changes and a loss of cell identity. Sinclair and his team have developed ICE mouses. ICE, standing for inducible changes in the epigenome. So no, these aren't mice driving ICE cars. This allowed them to induce DNA breaks and drive epigenetic changes that accelerate aging, resulting in faster aging mice. Work is now centered on reversing this aging process by reprogramming cells to be young again. In David Sinclair's words, if DNA is the digital information on a CD, then aging is due to scratches, and he is searching for the polish. He and his team have identified reprogramming factors that they believe will enable us to reset a cell's epigenetic status and reverse its age. Moreover, David Sinclair is also researching on the possibility of developing drugs that can slow down aging.
Nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, or short NAD+, has been identified as very important to repair DNA damage and to increase health span. This molecule has been found to decline with age. Sinclair famously takes NAD+ boosting supplements such as NMN in order to keep his NAD+ levels high. Another therapy form that could soon be here is myostatin inhibition. Myostatin is a protein that decreases bone and muscle mass and has been, from an evolutionary point of view, advantageous in periods of famine. There is evidence that inhibiting myostatin might increase lifespan by 10 to 20 years. This can be achieved by gene therapy. CRISPR-Cas9 gene editing is quickly becoming the tool of choice to edit our genes. And with researchers like Aubrey De Grey and David Sinclair pointing to engineered enzymes or engineered genes as a possible pathway to increase life and health span, it is quite clear that this will play a fundamental role for life extension.
So, you want to live on Mars, but you are 50 years of age or more? Then what can you do? Well, we have a few tips based on current research. First, you might want to eat as little as possible, as caloric restriction is at the moment the most effective way to increase lifespan. Then, NAD+ boosting supplements, such as NMN, might be worth a try. Also, don't smoke and don't drink too much alcohol. This means not more than a few glasses of wine per week. And for our Russian friends, no more than 1 bottle of vodka per day. So basically, try to live as healthy as possible until rejuvenation technology becomes widely available in the next 5 to 20 years. And who knows, people being born nowadays might live long enough to actually not age anymore at all. And no, overpopulation won't be a problem, since world population will start to decline sooner than we expect. Once we have reached saturation at around 12 billion people, so you will have a very good chance to live long enough to witness many more advances of humanity and even to live on Mars.
And if you live long enough, you might even see Elon become president of Mars, an idea about which we talked in this video here.
So thanks for watching the JS Disruption Report. And I would say, on to the future. We will be 200 at least. But I'm so happy we can talk about this topic again. Why is Sinclair such a cool name? But probably only because of Babylon 5.
Might add 9.